Hello and welcome back to Sam's Disney Diary. You know, it's hard to imagine today, but Snow White and the Seven Dwarfs wasn't released on home video until 1994. Until then, the only way to experience Snow White and the Seven Dwarfs was in a movie theater. Disney re-released Snow White to theaters 8 times, every 7 to 10 years, creating the tradition that became the Disney Vault for home video. That schedule meant that Disney needed to educate a new generation on the Disney classic to create demand for theater tickets. And that's exactly what this televised special did in 1983, The Fairest of Them All. Hosted by Dick Van Patten, the special includes many of the artists who worked on the film, including some of Walt's 9 old men, Ken Anderson, Frank Thomas, Ollie Johnson, Ward Kimball, all featured in the Disney family albums. It also reunites the voice of Snow White and the Prince. Appearances by Clarance, Ducky Nash, and a very young Drew Berrymore and Ricky Schroeder. They would have experienced the movie for the first time in movie theaters. Hit that subscribe button for more, and make sure you check out that playlist for the Disney Family album. There's so much great information there. This isn't the full televised special, but it's all I have. From 1983, The Fairest of Them All. Congaloosh!
Children's Museum and Walt Disney Productions welcome you to a tribute for the creators of Snow White and the Seven Dwarfs.
When I was younger, I saw Snow White as my mom. I thought she was a neat lady.
Snow White and the Seven Dwarfs has been popular for 4 generations. It's one thing children still have in common with their parents.
I like all the dwarfs. I like these two especially.
You know, it's amazing that it was made so long ago. You know, because it's really up to date in today's times.
Hard to believe, but back in 1937, no one, including these men who worked on the movie, knew if a feature-length cartoon could be made.
An hour and a half or 2 hours with animation or cartoon was unheard of.
You couldn't believe that anything like Snow White would go over with an audience.
But Walt knew that the big nut was in the feature-length cartoon.
Lots of critics, when they heard that Walt was going to make this feature, said, It'd be impossible to sit in a theater and watch a full-length cartoon. The colors would hurt your eyes. How can a cartoon girl and a prince who's drawn like a cartoon fall in love?
Disney won for Snow White. There's never been anything like it before or since. You see, there's one large Oscar and 7 smaller ones representing the 7 little dwarfs. Of course, their personalities gave them their names. There was Dopey, Grumpy, Sleepy, Happy, Sneezy, Bashful, and...
And Doc.
Oh, yes, Doc. Thank you very much.
Dwarfs' names fit their personalities. This pompous-looking individual is Doc, the self-appointed leader of the group.
Walt Disney knew that giving the dwarfs individual personalities would make them easy to remember, and he was right. Everybody who's seen the movie has a favorite dwarf.
I hate to say it, but I think it's Dopey. I'm sorry.
Sneezy!
You're Sneezy!
I better not say it in the presence of so many, but I guess it's Bashful.
Oh, gosh.
Say he's Sleepy. Somehow I like Sleepy.
I'd have to say Grumpy.
Next thing you know, she'll be tying her ears up in pink ribbons and smelling you up with that stuff called, her food.
Songs still inspire the woman who sang them. Adriana Caselotti was 18 when she recorded the voice of the fair princess.
My father was a singing teacher in Los Angeles, and one day one of the Walt Disney representatives called his studio and asked if he knew of someone who could sing and speak like a child. I was listening in on the extension phone upstairs, and I said, "Papa, how about me? Look, I can sing." And I went, so I came up with a makeup voice. I did not have that little girl voice.
I'm awfully sorry. I didn't mean to frighten you.
I'm awfully sorry.
I didn't mean to frighten you.
But you don't know what I've been through. And all because I was afraid.
I'm so ashamed of the fuss I've made.
What do you do when things go wrong?
Oh, you sing a song.
Someday my prince will come.
This is Harry Stockwell, who was the Prince Charming in Snow White and the Seven Dwarfs.
Oh, I just heard that Disney was looking for a voice. And I went out to the studio. They played this tape. They had several different voices on it. And this one voice came and I said, gee, that's a beautiful voice. She said, that's you.
Hello.
Oh.
Did I frighten you? Wait. Wait, please. Don't run away.
Now that I've found you, hear what I have to say. One song. I have but one song.
Now you.
One song only for you.
One heart tenderly. Come on, Harry, you're doing beautifully. One heart tenderly. Come on.
Tenderly beating.
Beautiful.
Ever entreating. Constant and true.
One love that has possessed me.
One love thrilling me through.
One song my heart keeps singing,
of one love only for you.
My favorite scene, where she comes, the queen comes down the stairs and looks to the witches. She's starting to leave, and here's the skeleton reaching out for the empty water pitcher. And she kicks it, you know, and says, have a drink, dearie. And I go, every time I see that thing.
Thirsty? Have a drink!
Her, not at all.
And my daughter begged to go home when the witch came on the screen, and I had to keep reassuring her there was a happy ending.
The whole rhythm of the scene begins to build. The animation becomes faster and more intense. The effects start to become more frightening. The rain starts, the backgrounds get darker, the expressions become more intense and closer in. So you really feel the intensity building this without really realizing it. It's a great film in the way that you have very evil, strong characters working with delicate, fragile, sensitive characters, working with humorous characters, and they all choreograph beautifully together.
Sneezy, grumpy, happy, bashful, sleepy, and...
And Doc!
And Doc, thank you very much. This is Dick Van Patten reminding you that 9 out of 10 magic mirrors agree. Snow White is still the fairest of them all.
Beyond the seven jeweled hills in the land of the seven dwarfs, you'll find adventure.
Now take a bite. We got a neighbor!
And magic.
Who is the fairest one of all?
Snow White.
Walt Disney's Snow White and the Seven Dwarfs, the fairest of them all. Rated G. Opens Friday at a theater near you. Check local listings.